Join me in welcoming Maestro Vito Nicola Paradiso.
Classica italiana, dalla canzone partenopea Napoli fino a
Domenico. So this year's, let's say this evening is devoted to Neapolitan music. So we wanted to speak Italian because of the week of Italian language. So go ahead.
Sì, dalla, appunto, dalla fine del 1800.
Starting from the 1800.
Il prossimo brano è sempre dello stesso periodo, fine 1800, ed è Amarecchiato.
So the end of the 1800 and same kind of theme, Mare Chiare.
brani sono del periodo della Prima Guerra Mondiale. E il primo brano appunto è Reginella.
With this year, because we're supposed to commemorate especially the First World War. So we started with the First World War, now we are going through the Second World War with the theme is?
With the dream
of going back to their society. and not to find their own reality bombed or destroyed because of the war. The second tune is Tamburiata Nera.
E racconta la storia, la curiosità di un bambino nato appunto nel periodo della guerra.
And it's the curiosity of a young child born during the war.
Un bambino appunto nato dalla zona di napoletana, con il colore di.
Born by a black Neapolitan woman.
Quindi la sorpresa di napoletani nel vedere.
So it's a surprise for the Neapolitans who are not used to see black people.
Thank you.
ritroviamo agli anni 50.
Somehow we are moving to the 50s.
It's the renewal, the rebirth of Italy after the war.
Due canzoni napoletane famosissime di quel periodo sono appunto Anima e Core.
Two very famous Neapolitan songs of that time were Anima e Core, which is soul and heart.
Tubo fa l'americana.
And You Want to Be American, Tubo fa l'americana, by Carosone. Enjoy.
Thank you.
un progetto nato qualche anno fa sulla figura di, del mio conterraneo Domenico Modugno.
This is a project that started a few years ago about his fellow citizen Domenico Modugno.
Mr. Volare,
as you know. Yeah.
Seguirò prima il brano che dà il titolo al volume. Che
I will play first the tune that is the title of the CD.
Una chitarra in frac, in realtà il brano è per il frac.
A guitar in frac, and actually what it is.
Il titolo del volume si chiama Una chitarra in frac, che riprende il titolo del brano.
Which is the very same title of the volume. And then if you are interested later, he has a few CDs also for sale. Thank you.
brani della tradizione siciliana. Modugno per molto tempo si pensava fosse siciliano, in realtà era pugliese. E per le esigenze appunto della RAI dell'epoca fu imposto di dire che fosse siciliano. E scrisse due brani molto belli. Il primo è Il pesce spada.
Thank you.
Maestro Nicola Paradiso for this beautiful journey through Italian music. And I'd like to remind you this year's theme of the Week of the Italian Language is L'Italiano della Musica, la musica dell'Italiano. And with this theme, I'd like to invite you to take a seat and stay with us for the second part of our evening. So, thanks again. And please do not forget to, after we are done here in the theater, to take a look at the exhibition Milano da Leggere, which is an exhibition on the theme also Expo Milan with the Fondazione Mondadori. Please have a look afterwards in our gallery. An Italian musician who made his mark in an influential Italian producer, songwriter, performer, and DJ, the founder of disco and pioneer of electronic music, Giorgio Moroder. Over the course of his career, Mr. Moroder has worked with some of the most famous names of music, including Barbara Streisand, Elton John, Cher, Janet Jackson, and David Bowie. He's heavily noted for being the key player in Donna Summer's rise to fame through the 70s, collaborating with her on her biggest hits. In 1997, Moroder and Summer won the Grammy Award for Best Dance Recording for the song Carry On. Giorgio Moroder is also responsible for timeless soundtrack numbers like Take My Breath Away, Top Gun, Aaron Skinner, Flashdance, Blondie's Call Me, American Gigolo, as well as compositions of films such as Scarface and The Neverending Story, just to mention a few. From this, he has won 3 Academy Awards, 4 Golden Globes, 4 Grammys, and more than 100 gold and platinum records. Giorgio Moroder was inducted into the Dance Music Hall of Fame in 2004. He still has his hands in the center of electro dance music culture, swinging back into the spotlight in 2013 as guest collaborator on the Grammy Award-winning Daft Punk album Random Access Memories, earning his 3rd Grammy Award for Album of the Year, and as an acclaimed live DJ at major global festivals and clubs all over the world. His album Deja Vu, released in 2015, features collaborations with Kylie Minogue, Britney Spears, Sia, and more. The album reached number 1 in the US on the Billboard of Dance Electronic Charts. Now, before we watch a video, I'd like to thank once again the Honorable Consul General of Italy for being with us. And in a few minutes, we'll have the pleasure of having Giorgio Moroder too. Video, please.
Thank you. Thank you. The music of my guest tonight has dominated the charts, the silver screen, and the dance floor. Fusing European electronica and American R&B, he is credited with inventing an entire new genre, electronic dance music. Creating the synthesizer, the backbone of a whole new sound, and collaborating with legendary soul diva Donna Summer, he created timeless and, dare we say, orgasmic classics like I Feel Love and Love to Love You, Baby. Moving to Hollywood, he went on to create groundbreaking film soundtracks, picking up Oscars for Midnight Express, Flashdance, and Top Gun, while topping the charts yet again with massive hits like Take My Breath Away, Call Me, and What a Feeling. Writer, composer, arranger, and producer, he's worked with artists as diverse as Barbara Streisand, Sparks, Phil Oakey, and David Bowie. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Disco King, Electro Maestro, and the Beethoven of the BPM, Mr. Giorgio Moroder.
Hello, Asheville. My name is Giovanni Giorgio.
But you can call me Giorgio. sometime, I think in June, July of 59, I got the offer to become a professional musician. So I could not say no. First I played guitar and then I played bass, and that's how I started. Well, I really liked the Beatles. At that time I was a musician. I was 22, 23, and it was astonishing how interesting melodies, arrangement, voices, harmony, how great they were. And I think they really influenced me a lot. And then, on the other hand, some bubblegum, like I loved the Ohio Express, yummy, yummy, I gotta love it, my tummy, things like that. Well, first of all, Donna Summer was great because I discovered her. She was really working with me well. She was listening what I would say. She's very talented. She has a great voice. She plays piano. She was singing. She did write very nice lyrics. So I think that was probably the best, and especially that we did probably 100 songs. So that was a long relationship. Probably Scarface, because it's a long movie. Although I must say I didn't compose a lot of music. De Palma did not really want a lot, but still, in 3.5 hours, or 3 hours and 20, that's a lot of movie. It's probably the first one, Midnight Express. Alan Parker said he just needs one great track for the scene where the kids runs away, and he wanted something similar to I Feel Love. And once I had that one, he let me do whatever I wanted, and it was great because I didn't have any idea of how you do a soundtrack for a movie, because I never did any. And so I just did whatever I thought was could work, and he was happy, and that was an easy, probably the most easy one I did. Well, I like the sounds of EDM. The guys create new sounds, beautiful sounds. The melodies, it's a little less. The melodies, I like the melodies, the kind of melodies I did with Donna Summer or with Flashdance, where you have a verse, a chorus, a setup, a song setup. Right now it's a little more difficult or different because sometimes it's 8 bars of one piece of music and then 8 bars of a different one. They're all great, but the connection sometimes is not there. So that I think it's the biggest difference. I'm most surprised by the fact that when I play my old songs that young people know them. And some know lyrics, some know the whole lyrics of the whole songs. And I must say, it must be the internet, because otherwise how would a 20-year-old guy know a song which was composed 20 years before he was ever born?
What a great audience. This is the best. See you next year. Yeah. Okay, good night.
Present him the Italian Cultural Institute Lifetime Achievement Award. Just a few words about the prize. Since 2005, the Institute has awarded it to distinguished individuals who best represent Italian excellence in the arts, culture, and science in the world. Recipients are Ennio Morricone, Claudia Cardinale, Vittorio Storaro, Pupi Avati, Francis Ford Coppola, Dino De Laurentiis, Milena Calonero for cinema, Sergio Pininfarina and Massimo Vignelli for design, Claudio Magris and Dacia Mareini for literature, Renato Dulbecco for medicine, Renzo Piano, Tobias Scarpa, and Cini Boeri for architecture. Today, it is my pleasure and an honor to award with the Honorable Consul General of Italy, Giorgio Moroder.
Grazie. Okay. 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 Okay.
I think we all know this song, right? Grazie, maestro. Now, Giorgio.
Thank you, Istituto, per questo, in inglese. Thank you for this beautiful award. It's going to be next to, I guess, next to my Oscar. And this is a special reward because I have several beautiful awards, but this is so special. Especially, it's coming from Italy. And if I may just give you a little bit of an idea about how I started. I was born in Otise, in Val Gardena, and I left Italy when I was 19, went through all Europe as a musician, and then finally I decided I should become a composer, which I always wanted to be, but never really tried. So I ended up in Berlin, because I had an aunt there where I could stay for like 3 years, because you know, to start to become a composer, even if you have a good song or two or three, until you make money, it takes a long time. So I was happy there, but then I moved to Munich. And in Munich that's where I met Donna Summer. And we had two good songs, but then finally I did one song which was my first big hit, and certainly Donna Summer's, which is Love to Love You Baby, which I think it's quite sexy, a sexy song. So I continued with her. I had some other productions, and then finally she decided to come back home to to the States, and where my dear friend was, I had to be too. So I moved to the States in 1980. And I'm here since then. It's, yeah, 35 years. And talking about Italy, first of all, I love to speak Italian. I don't have that much occasion, although when I go to Italy, of course, I speak Italian or Ladino. I'm from Val Gardena. And to keep up with the language, I do crossword puzzles. I must admit, I do one puzzle a day. So it's really nice because I get, let's say the other day they asked what's the name of the a TV show, which I obviously don't know. So I go into the internet and I read. So it's great for my head, for my mind. And the other thing is I read every day. I read Corriere, I read La Repubblica, so I know who Rienzi is. And we go back about two, three times a year in Val Gardena. In fact, we just came back. We were there most of the summer. And so now I'm here, and I thank you very much for this big, great honor. And by the way, I have an album out. No, it's interesting. I started to become a DJ. So I'm officially the oldest DJ in the world. I was 74, and I still do it. In fact, we are going to have an incredible program in the next few months. Just so that you know the life of a DJ, it's beautiful, but it's tough. So the 5th of November, we're going to London. The 6th, I have a show in London. Then we go to Dublin. Then we go back to Germany. Then we go to Oslo. Then I think we go back to London. Then I go into Italy. In Milano, I do the special guest for the Italian X Factor. Then the day after, still in Milano, then to Napoli. From Napoli, we go to, and of course, my tour manager is arranging everything, so I just have to work, and that's all. And then we go to Istanbul. Istanbul, we go to Manila. Manila to Jakarta. Jakarta back to Switzerland, and then back here. So it's going to be tough, but I love it. I love it. And in the meantime, I had a big hit with a song with the group Daft Punk, which the song is called Giorgio by Moroder, where I tell my story. And so they took part of the 2 hours of my talk with them and made a song out. So I talk and they play, and they did a very good job, a very, very interesting recording. And then I was offered to do an album, so I did an album which came out about three, four months. And I have some of the top artists in the world. I have Britney Spears, Kylie Minogue, a new girl called Sia. I don't know if you know Sia. Two great singers, Mickey Echo, Matthew Coma, who else? Kylie Minogue. So basically, the Daft Punk got me back to work. Because for the last 10, 15 years, I did a lot of golf. Sorry? Oh, no, I'm talking about music. I play golf, and I still do all my puzzles. And by the way, is anybody here doing puzzles? Settimana Mystica? You do? Do you know that there's one, can I just talk about? There, because I need your help. There is one, it's called Difficilissimo. Where you know that one, the last one? I'm stuck. I checked every internet possible to get a clue where to put the words, but so I'm okay, no help. Okay, that's okay. So I keep up what's going on. And you know, with the music, the Italian music is really good, but unfortunately it's a little local. It's very difficult to get out of Italy with Italian songs. First, the language is beautiful, probably the most beautiful language, and especially to sing, but worldwide, it's not most, 95% is English. So that's a little bit of a problem for French. Spanish is better because Spanish has all South America. But Italian has many beautiful songs, and apart from Eros Ramazzotti, who is doing well, and especially Zucchero, who is very good, it's a little bit of a problem outside Italy. But I'm happy to have helped a little bit with my music, and I'm really proud about a song I did for the World Cup in Italy, Italia 90, a song called Un'estate Italiana with Gianna Nannini. And we just came back from Argentina. And I did a special mix, a disco mix, dance mix of the song, and it was incredible. They told me that if you sing that song, the house is going to collapse. In fact, people were singing with the lyrics. You know, Argentina has, I think, about 30, 40% Italians, although few people I noticed speak it, but they all know the song, and I think at least in South America, that's probably the Italian song which is the most known, apart from Pavarotti and Bocelli. So that's it for me, and I thank you very much, and I think I told most of my life.
There you go.
Thank you.
So now you know what the mustache was. Actually, it was his gift, because he's the spokesperson for the Week of Italian Language. è nostro padrino della settimana della lingua italiana nel mondo, quindi adesso sapete chi era. Now you know who the mustache was on our cover.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, yeah, that's me, but only half.
Only half of it because it was too small.
Okay, can I keep?
Sure,
okay,
of course.
Thank you.
Allora, volevo sapere che rapporto hai tu con l'Italia e l'italiano in particolare.
Beh, l'italiano lo parlo poco perché qua ho degli amici, però non è che lo parlo tutti i giorni, però faccio le parole incrociate in italiano, solo in italiano. Leggo i giornali italiani, due o tre volte alla settimana parlo con i miei in Italia, parlo italiano, e quando sono in Italia.
Cioè, quindi mantieni sempre attivo?
Sì.
Grazie ancora di essere stato il nostro padrino d'eccezione, e so che hai fatto anche un'intervista per la lingua batte con la RAI.
Ah sì.
È andata bene?
Sì, molto gentile.
Grazie ancora.
Okay.